Stugatz, what are you objecting to when I say, I mean, I don't think it's up for dispute. If you left with 28 seconds left, down 5 last night, you gave up on your team. Like, what are you objecting to in that statement? I think that's a 100% fact without dilution. You gave up on your team. Otherwise, you would not have left.
Yeah, no, what I'm objecting to is the odds of the Heat coming back in that spot, as we've discussed, is 1 in 100, maybe, okay? And I understand fans. Dan, I'm certain there were a bunch of fans who were there for the first time last night, and they left early, and they should be criticized. But there were also a lot of fans, because I walked out with them, that are legitimate fans that were crying, that were upset, and felt like the team didn't have a shot of coming back and didn't want to witness what they saw 2 years ago with Dallas.
But you gave up on your team.
Okay. Yeah, Dan's right, though. I mean, I understand that there's legitimate fans, but clearly, if you thought they had a chance to win, you would not have left.
Or if you didn't want to see, yes, I agree with you on that.
You got to just eat that one, okay? Yes. You just have to eat
no,
it. You gave up on your team.
You have to own that one.
I don't have to eat it. I really don't. I think it happens all the time in a lot of different cities.
Okay, those people gave up on their team, too.
But if you don't own that, then, Stu, what you're saying is, no, I thought they had a chance to win, but I decided to leave
anyway. I just didn't
want
to watch it.
No. Stan, you're not going to buy it all. There were certain people who felt, yes, you gave up on your team. I'm granting you that.
That's okay. Well, that's all we're saying.
Okay, but aren't there, I mean, there's legitimate excuses for leaving, and one of them in my mind is not wanting to see the Spurs celebrate.
And you gave up on your team.
Fine. Okay. Even if that's true, you only do that when you're sure the game is decided.
I'm pretty sure right there.
I don't think, I may be wrong about this, okay? Because fans do leave early all over the country. But man, I don't think, maybe I'm wrong. I don't think that what this team has given this market for 3 years and the relevance of the games and the way this entire season felt, I don't think that that happens in a lot of other markets with that intensity.
I mean, the Patriots have given a lot to their city over the last 15 years, and that place was half empty towards the end of the Ravens game.
But they were
game.
Getting crushed. It's not 5 points with 28 seconds left. Well, I mean, it's not a missed free throws. Yeah, they were leaving as Ginobili went to the line up 4. That's when the exodus began.
Okay, but you position it as, you know, the Heat fans, because what this team has given you over 3 years, that you should sit there while losing and give everyone a standing ovation at the end of the season. Like, that's...
Well, I actually do feel...
Okay,
that
but fans
should
are,
be...
You know I, fans aren't...
Well, but I actually do feel that this team deserves that kind of gratitude. 3 straight finals appearances, leaving what they have on the court. I do believe this team deserves a special kind of gratitude. Yeah. Because they've given us 3 years of ridiculous.
I agree they have, but fans, a lot of fans aren't wired like it. Some are, a lot aren't.
Stan, would you like to talk to some fans who left the game early and were banging on the doors? And would you? Yes, I'll take it. Jordan, you're on the ticket, Jordan.
Well, first of all, I wasn't banging on the glass to get back in. I know that you can't get back in the stadium. Number one. Number two, I am a diehard fan, season ticket holder. I could not fathom watching. I left with 30 seconds. I couldn't fathom watching the Spurs win the series. I was there when the Mavericks won. It was painful. I actually watched it. Those memories were coming. Like I felt like it was like all over again. The Mavericks series.
Gave up on your team.
I don't call it giving up. It was the pain.
You don't have to call it that, but that's what it is.
The pain was just so much. It was like hurting inside.
But you gave up on him.
Yeah, that's how I feel every day.
I'm with Stugatz, man. I mean,
you left early too, just like Stugatz.
Yeah, but Stugatz,
what's more painful, Jordan? Having to realize you gave up on your team or having to say that you're with Stugatz?
You've been with me before, Stan.
I mean, that's where, Jordan, you got a losing argument when the branch you're hanging on to is I'm with Stugatz.
Jordan, stay right here. Don't listen
Stugatz,
to these.
And he makes me laugh.
Right? Yeah, that's right, Jordan. Don't listen to these two elitist snobs over here, okay?
But, you know what? In a way, I felt like I sacrificed.
Yeah, my friend feels the exact same way. He does. In fact, he says if they're down 5, 30 seconds to go game 7, he's doing the same exact thing.
What kind of rationalization is this?
It is. It's a sacrifice.
Well, in other words, if I stayed, it might have not been the same. I might have, like, changed the space-time continuum or whatever.
Right. Yep. No, you are dead on, yeah. man. You are dead on.
I wish that I could change the space-time continuum so that you wouldn't have given up on your team.
I mean, way to leave. Way to leave.
Way to leave.
Way to leave. Way to leave. Way to leave.
Jordan's a hero.
Yes.
Jordan's the unsung hero from Game 6. Bleep Ray Allen. Jordan leaving. More responsible for the victory than the headband.
MVP.
What?
Huh? Dan Levitard.